Hi everyone, I'm Sherry from QuantConnect. In this lesson, we'll create a sector-balanced portfolio by implementing a portfolio construction model, which allocates capital equally to each sector. We'll select a universe of equities from the technology, financial services, and consumer goods sectors. So in this first task, we'll set up our universe of assets, which we'll later use to build a balanced portfolio. A sector balance portfolio strategy invests in assets across industries. Its goal is to expose the portfolio to less risk from a specific sector and generate more robust returns through a variety of market conditions. To create our sector balance portfolio strategy, we're going to work with the algorithm framework. To start, let's tell the framework to use an instance of our new custom universe selection model. In previous lessons, we discussed how to do universe selection with coarse and fine filters to choose a universe of assets. The template provides a predefined coarse selection method that we have right here. This returns the top 100 most liquid securities. We'll focus mainly on our fine filter. In QuantConnect, we have Morningstar fundamental data for approximately 5,000 US equities. Fundamental selection filters can use Morningstar data each day to select assets for the algorithm. Using the fundamental data provided, we can select assets by returning a list of symbol objects we'd like for our algorithm. We're going to use two properties with this data, asset classification and market cap. The asset classification property is the stock's sector's classification, according to Morningstar. We can use the Morningstar sector code enum as the shortcut for accessing these numbers. And we can see what I mean here with the Morningstar sector code property and the market cap property. All right, let's put this together and filter for the top three securities sorted by market cap for the technology sector. We'll save the symbol objects to the variable self.technology. We can see an example of how we want to filter and sort here. And just like the example, we can set filtered and then sort for our technology list. For the objects that have come through in fine, if the sector code is technology, then let's add it to the list filtered. Then we'll sort the filtered list by market cap. And here we're going to use the reverse equals true parameter so we can get the highest values of market cap. We'll use an array slice to take three objects and save them to the variable. Next, let's filter for the top two securities in the financial services sector. So we just did technology, now we're going to do financial services. And save the symbol objects to the variable self.financial services. And we're just getting these codes from earlier in the objectives description. Finally, let's add the top security in the consumer goods sector, known as consumer defensive, sorted by market cap, and save that to the variable self.consumerDefensive. All right, let's submit and see how we did. Okay, cool. Let's continue on to the next task. Now let's set up our sector weighting portfolio construction model. Let's revisit the portfolio construction model first, which we'll refer to as PCM. The model generates targets for trade execution systems. These portfolio targets come from the insights provided by the alpha model. We're going to create a new PCM, which inherits from the equal weighting portfolio construction model, to reuse most of its features. We would like the capital assigned to each sector to be fixed, to minimize the risk exposure to a specific sector. We'll override the equal weighting behavior for portfolio target creation to build the sector weighting functionality. Let's set an instance of the sector weighting portfolio construction model. The rebalancing parameter sets the rebalancing frequency of portfolio construction models. To preserve its functionality in our new model, we'll pass through the rebalance parameter to the base class. When passing arguments to the base class, you use Python's superfunction prefix. Let's edit the class constructor to accept a rebalance parameter and set it to daily resolution. Now let's initialize the underlying class constructor by passing through rebalance to the super constructor. In the constructor, we'll initialize an empty dictionary, which we'll use to group the securities by sector code in the next task. Now let's submit and see how we did. Okay, great. On to the next one. So far, we've set up the structure for our sector weighting. Now let's use onSecurities changed events to track how many securities are in each sector. As securities are added, we'll add the symbol to a list for that sector in a symbol by sector code dictionary. For this strategy, we'll assign each sector in the universe an equal weight. Each sector has a different number of securities, so we'll need to calculate security weights. For this task, we'll keep track of the insights in sectors using a dictionary. Now, the dictionary keys are sector codes, and the values are lists of security symbols in that sector. For objective one, when new assets are added to the universe, let's save the sector code for each security to a variable. Fundamental data for securities can be accessed using the fundamentals property on that security object. Thank you. Fundamentals data is only accessible on assets selected from the fine universe selection. We can check if the asset symbol is in our dictionary with a not in statement and use the append function if the symbol is not already there. Let's do that for objective two. Now, next, we'll repeat the first step that we took of saving the sector code variable so we can access the sector code easily. Then finally, if the sector code is in the dictionary, and if the symbol is in that sector's list, then let's remove the symbol from the list. To remove a value from a list, we can use the remove function. What we've created is a dictionary that is updated each time the securities in our universe change. Again, the dictionary keys are the sector codes, and the values are lists of symbol objects. Now let's see how we did. Okay, super, we passed. In the next task, we'll use our dictionary of sector codes and symbols. We'll allocate an equal buying power to each sector and translate this into an allocation per security. The capital assigned to each sector depends on the number of sectors in your universe. In this case, we've got three sectors, and we're assuming it will use a full buying power of one. We'll save the buying power allocation per sector to a variable. We can use the length of the dictionary to get the number of sectors. Let's do that now. The base class tracks the currently active insights from the algorithm alpha model and provides a list of currently active signals to the determine target percent method. Active insights are insights from the alpha model which have not expired and should receive a target allocation. Let's get the active insights for a specific sector. We can use list comprehension and use the symbol by sector code dictionary generated in the previous task and save the results to insights in sector. Next, let's determine the security allocation percent based on the sector allocation divided by the number of insights in that sector. We've already calculated the sector allocation, which we saved to self.sector buying power. And we also already know the number of securities in the sector, which is in self.insights in sector. Finally, we'll iterate through the insights in our sector and return a target percent for each insight. The allocation is calculated by multiplying the insight direction by our sector insight percent. We'll use insight direction to indicate a long or short position. The base class turns the target percentages into a precise number of shares, portfolio targets, and delivers them to the execution model. All right, let's submit. Looking good. All right, congratulations. You've just passed the sector-weighted portfolio construction bootcamp. Thanks for joining me on this tutorial. See you in the next one.